it's Sunday. Rocky Nats number one. It's run and done. How good has it been?
It is run and done, and it has been unbelievable. We've been talking about it for quite a few months, and we've wanted to go, and it was full and all this. And, mate, it was packed. Entrance were full, spectators were full. Everywhere you went, there was six or seven deep. The cruise, six or seven deep on that cruise, there was over 800 cars. So just the whole thing was amazing.
Yeah, absolutely. So we thought we'd start the podcast off today. We don't need an introduction to the show. We just kick it off straight away with,
Yeah, look at this car.
Darren is such, and this is quite a HK you've got there, mate.
That's right.
Feel free to hold the mic and let us know what sort of weekend you've had.
So firstly, just give us a little bit of a, this is Darrell O'Sullivan. He's had this car built at BMW, is that right, by Chris?
Yep.
So give us a little bit of your background. How long you been a car guy?
My old man was in the car, so I pretty much got it off him. He done his father's car he rebuilt in his shed when I was only a kid, so we were always helping him do that. So yeah, guess it pretty well started from there.
What sort of car was that?
It was a Humber Super Snipe, come from England.
So
he rebuilt that. Took him a long time to do that, and we helped out with that. But yeah, I guess pretty well started from there.
What do you do now for a job?
I got my own business. I'm a boilermaker, got a welding and fabrication business, work up in the mines and stuff. So
is this your first car?
Yeah.
First like car to this level?
Yeah, first car to this level, and it is my first car I ever had. I got it from when I was 15, so I've had it since then.
How good's that? That's fantastic. So, as I was just saying there, most of this was done at Chris's at BMW, who also built the current Summer Nats champion, which is Charlie Harley's 57 Chev. But give us a little bit of a rundown of what's been done to this.
It was only really meant to be just a bit of a street car.
But I've never heard that before.
But it got out of hand. But yeah, we've pretty much done everything to it, from get rid of quarter windows, extend the seals, chassis rails.
Tailgates
welded up, cowls are welded up. Yeah, pretty much everything, just to make it. We didn't want to go away too much from the HK look, but just refine.
And you absolutely achieved that. That's one thing I really love about this vehicle. As soon as you look at it, you recognise it as a HK Holden ute, but then when you start really looking at it, the fabrication is just mind-boggling. That engine bay is mad, isn't it?
Yeah, Chris come up with that idea. We just want to do something in the engine bay to sort of present it a bit more, and yeah, Chris being the skills that he got, he just whips it up out of nowhere, so.
I just wanted to say, the more I spent a bit of time looking at this car yesterday, and the more I walked around it, the more things I found that were unique to this car. Unbelievable amount of, did you plan it to do that way, all of it, or just like do that and then you go, oh, that might work with that, or that will work, and as you go?
We had some things planned that we wanted to do, but then along the way you go, you're like, oh, what if we do this, or we've done this now, so we've got to do this now, and it just keeps going and going until you're finally like, oh, that's what we want, that's what we ended up with.
How many years in the build?
Probably been about eight. Went to a couple other shops that were no good before, and then got hold of Chris, and I can't thank him enough. He sort of took on a bit of a basket case from the start, and
he's really stepped up. Hey, he's built the Valiant for Jason, and then he got Charlie's 57 Chev, and now this, and I believe he's got some pretty other trick cars in the build, right?
Down there the other day, he's got a fair few on the build at the moment. Got two charges on the go that will be up.
So,
there.
But more important, tell us what you won this weekend.
I won People's Choice, so pretty stoked with that.
Yeah.
And I won down to Motorex, so we'll be going down there as well.
Yeah, Superstars finalist.
I have no doubt this car will draw many heads at Motorex walking around, because I must have spent half an hour yesterday and I've had no time to scratch my neck, so it's unbelievable. When you build a car like to this level, did you expect it to be this level at the start?
No.
Not at all.
No.
When Callum done the paint, we went and was back at his house in his shed, and we went around, down on the sunny coast one weekend. We went and had a look at it, and I sort of walked through the door and I'm like, oh, geez, I don't think I should be driving this.
So, speaking of the paint, awesome colour. What is it?
Brandy wine on House of Colour over a black base.
Yeah, amazing colour.
Yeah, come up really light. It changes in the dark. It's a lot darker in here, but put it in the sun, it really pops in the sun.
Did that change a few times? Like, did you, was it ever
we
always?
We were looking at the Mazda Soul Red, yeah. And then Cal done a couple of spray outs, and we done one over grey and one over black, and the grey was a bit more lighter, so we went with the black and went with a house of colour. So.
And we unveiled this awesome vehicle here this weekend, so what's next now? Obviously you got your qualified superstars from Maguire's Motorex, but what else you got coming up?
Oh, I'm looking for a Monaro at the moment, so yeah, just got something with a few more doors. Probably not exactly the same treatment as this, but something along them lines.
What about events? You got any other events? I'm gonna twist your arm to come to Red Centre.
Oh yeah, we're looking at Red Centre now. It's one in Mackay, they've got a car show in Mackay, yep. In September. Obviously go to Motorex, Summon Ads. So yeah, we'll be pretty most of them anyway, about.
I guess, just in terms of driving it, had you planned when you first started to build, like, I'm gonna drive this car a lot, and now you're like, uh-oh.
Yeah, it was. It was meant to be just driven all the time, but I've already had it out a couple of times, I can't help myself, so yeah, yeah. They're still making paint, so.
Yeah,
it'll be the first stone chip, it'll be pretty sad after that, but then
still making paint.
Yeah, no point, no fun sitting in the shed anyway, so
yeah, nice,
it was built to drive. I'll do the show for a while, then yeah, then she'll be a driver.
I look forward to seeing it at Motorex for sure.
Yeah, me too. Thanks, Daryl. I really appreciate your time and congratulations again. Car went over awesome here, as you actually won People's Choice by quite a significant way, so very popular. Very popular choice. Well done, mate.
Right,
see you around.
Thanks very much.
How special is this? Look who I've found out the back there. He was asleep in his trailer. Billy Shelton, who happens to own this car. Thanks, mate. Thanks for Rocky. What'd you think of it?
Oh, it's unreal. Loved it. It was bloody great.
So, give us a little bit of background of you to start with. You've been around for a while. You've had a few cars. How'd you get into cars and what do you do?
I probably watched Paul when I was about 12 at Redcliffe cruising around. I was on a pushy. And went from there, and then I built the Sicko HQ two-door.
Yeah.
And just took it from there.
So, where's that car?
Some bits at home nearly getting done. So, you can see they come out hopefully next year, at the end of the year.
So, what's the story with this car actually here this weekend? You've won top comp, engine bay and a paint award. So, I didn't even know you're building this car. So, what's going on with that?
We just been running the pump flat out with the HQ, and we just wanted to do something to have a bit of fun in and do a bit of racing, stop racing motorbikes and getting injured, more or less.
So I reckon this guy sitting here's done most of the work, is that right?
Oh yeah, I lifted a diff in one night.
Yeah, Billy helped me with the diff. and he complained
heavy.
About it.
It was heavy.
Okay. Tell us about the build.
It wasn't meant to just, you know, when people say it yeah. wasn't meant and it yeah. got out of control,
yeah.
Well, that's Billy. If you look that up in the dictionary, that's Billy, right? When COVID hit, we weren't sure what was going on with the show scene, and we were just casually doing his Monaro. It's an elite car. We're taking our time with it. And so I had this car. This is a Long Reach car, like a rust-free car. I got off a friend of my dad's.
Yeah, nice.
This Always car an is yours.
This car was mine, yeah, I bought it out of Longreach, yep.
Which is an important part of a build to make it the process, pick a good shell.
100%,
yeah.
And off camera, Justin's sitting over there, and I took Billy for I took Billy for a ride in Justin's car, and Justin's car's a twin turbo HQ wagon, makes 1,060 horsepower or whatever, and we had it turned down to about 750, and I took him for a drive because I'm trying to tell him that we don't want to make 2,000 horsepower on his show car, right? Trying to convince him. So I've taken him for a drive in this turbo car, and he's gone, I want 300. I want 300. Anyway, so buddy fell in love with the torque of a turbo, so we thought we'd do a budget. Fun thing we could race, you know.
Yep.
So we rolled out the budget, and it was going to be fairly cheap and and fairly good.
And very unique. You built this car in under 12 months, haven't you?
Way under. So we casually built it for nothing like it is now. And it's about 4 months that we... No, it was probably the 12th of January I really started it.
Yeah.
So I come back after Christmas break, and then I'll be flat out.
This year?
This year.
Yeah.
100%.
Did you hear that, everyone?
Yeah.
This year.
Yeah.
Because we've just been talking to people, cars have been in the build for 6 years, eight years.
That's right.
Yeah.
And I mean, we only...
It takes people 3 months to think what plate they're going to get.
And in COVID as well, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, don't worry about the plates. He's got every one that says six something on it. So there was no worries about the plates. But, like, give you an idea of our time frame. I repaired that bonnet on Sunday night. And what are we, Sunday night? So
yeah,
1 week
wow,
ago.
Wow.
So and that's look, how, you know what I mean? Like our time frame was so crazy to get it done.
Yeah.
But the car is not a show car. It was never meant to be a show car. We've had a couple of conversations about people on the weekend. They're going, oh, you've picked a show car and you've done a VL Calais with all the molds and the plastic. Mate, this is going to run 8 second pass, right?
Paul, I was just going to say, the other thing pretty amazing about this car, I think this is the first time it's rolled out of the trailer. Fired up. We went down the street drags this morning.
Yeah.
Fired up. Like, drove it down.
Yeah.
Drive it. Do the two passes. Drive it back.
I was up the other end. It sounds good.
And we never turned it off. We were like street car. So we ran it for an hour and a half. Because it's unique, right? So we've got the radiators in the back.
So that's
a little bit different. So we've got the turbo turned. To be different, it's not on the side, you know what I mean? Like they all do them, so we're trying to do something different and make it look different and make it work, and it works unreal. So we had it on Justin's Horsepower Solutions dyno and it was about 34 degrees in the, and we had it running for like an hour and a half when we're setting up the water meth, because we've got no intercooler, it's water meth.
Yeah.
And the fans turned on three times or something, didn't they, Bill? We ran for 3 seconds or something. It works amazing. So it worked out fine. I bled the brakes. Sorry, bedded the brakes in at his property. It's got a couple hundred meter driveway. And then when he's doing the go to woe today, I'm panicking because I'm like, mate, it's raining and we haven't done anything. You know what I mean? Billy, just be careful. It's all right.
Oh, I tell him to be careful.
Yeah, I know.
Right.
I know.
It's like a soccer dad on the sideline, man.
But yeah.
I rocked up in thongs. Hey, how
I'm shocked.
Yeah. But this car's going to the drag strip. That's what's happening. So we're going to get Billy's license. I'm going to do his passes, and we'll work. We're not going to be stupid and just go out and.
What do you reckon that'll run for?
We only got 750 in it at the moment. That motor's made 1,000 horsepower in another car, but we just ran out of time, so we stopped. Like, we're just coming here. We don't need 300 horsepower.
It's a show.
Exactly. Yeah. So it'll go back to Justin's. We'll make 1,000. We haven't used the nitrous yet or anything like that. It's got a bit of fluff, Owen, right? Which a bit of show fluff, which kills me because I like to be light for racing. I reckon we're about 500 pounds of fluff on it, so we're about a half a second slower than we would say. So it might be a little bit harder, but we've got a backup motor, haven't we, Bill?
Yeah,
we
are. So you're talking about all this and all the things you're doing with this. What is the HQ? What's
all
going
right.
on?
All right, so the
real car.
Yeah. So the HQ is in primer on the rotisserie, ready to go. So we've got very minimal work for that to happen, and we'll start the painting process for that. But there's no. I kept saying, Billy, when we're doing this, we're not doing this to you, Manara, mate.
No.
This is crazy. I was working 20 hours a day. The last stretch, we did 40 hours straight to get it here. So, and I get a bit cranky. And I had a go at Billy. And Billy's
he's an easier
scapegoat for me to. Yeah, so no, but it's all cool, mate. We're mates and we have a go at each other all the time. And it was good, eh? We had, like, it was good.
I enjoyed it. Like, if it wasn't for Paul, I wouldn't have that because it's dear to do. And Paul did that out of a favour because we've done the Monaro and it's up and down, you know.
the build.
Yeah.
And he did that to help me out, which he does that, you know. I couldn't afford to do it if he didn't help me all those hours. Yeah.
I know, I'm wasting away.
Talking to a few people at the event and walking around, a lot of people are talking about the car like that. I think they love the, let's call it what it is. It looks badass, you know, and it's doubt, and it sounds so good today. Yeah, I mean, obviously we'd never had a big crowd there. It was just for the
100%
event they were running, but when that gets to the track, it's gonna, you know, it's gonna turn some heads. But no doubt for you both of you wanted to perform.
Yeah. It's going to perform. It's going to be mad.
Yeah.
It'll be mad.
Mad.
Mad. No, it'll...
We want to run a 7 in it really.
No, we don't. Yeah. No. This is what happens.
I was smelling the 7.
We go. This is what happens, see? We're building a car. Now we're on a podcast. It's going 7.
Jeez. I was
sniffing into your head. You're going, I'd like 7, but I'm never going to say that.
No. We'll run an 8 in it. Later on, we could. It's got all the good stuff. Don't get me wrong.
You take this kind of car to drag challenge, something like
100%.
That? 100%. Yeah. Awesome. So
100%. This car could do any of those things.
Yeah.
It's got all good AFCOs. Yeah. Your long travel. It's got all the good stuff in it. Right.
Runs cool, like you said. So there's good tests there to do some stuff. Yeah.
And we've been playing that up all weekend. We just let it run. So when we come back from the trophy presentation, we just turned it on.
Yeah.
And it ran for like over an hour in here.
Yeah. Wow.
Just because. So many people have asked us about the cooling system, and it's not a street car. You know,
I think it's inspirational. A lot of people it's nice to have a drag car thing and have them nice too, you know?
Yeah.
So, and the fact you've done it in such a short amount of time, but no doubt bloody hard work.
But it's a different thing in his Monaro because nothing's hidden.
Yeah.
We didn't hide anything, did we, Bill? We said that from the start. Yeah, yeah. So all the hoses, all the vacuum lines, all the wiring, everything, because you've got to work on it at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Well, one thing with that is this still got second...
No, it's got best engine bay.
Top engine bay.
Which means a lot to me, that one.
And it does, because you don't have to hide everything. It's actually harder to have that much stuff on an engine and make it look good.
Yeah, 100%.
So that means that you've really thought about it, planned it out.
Yeah.
So do you work for him full time?
Well, this year I have, from January the 12th I have.
Commiseration.
And I don't know, does 150 hours a week, does that constitute full time?
No.
Yeah, I don't know. Usually it's a few days a week, but that stupid brainstorm of his that, and I reckon it was your fault.
It wasn't me.
Bringing it up to Rocky's going, I think I want to go to Rocky and unveil this thing. Oh my God. But no.
I've never had a fast. I've had a car. I'm not fast. I want to get into it. Have a bit of fun.
And drive it though. But it's got LS platform. They've got hydraulic cams in them. You can drive them. The cams aren't huge. They're great.
And you run a nice amount of boost and you'll make good power.
100%. Yeah. 100%. So we'll put, maybe 24 pound into this thing,
and we still got E85.
It's grout filled, the block.
Yeah.
So it, which is free, will freak out as well because we've got the radiator in the back, and it's grout filled, and you can't drive a grout filled car on the street, but of course you can.
And you couldn't have.
I saw you do it today.
You couldn't have chose a better colour. It actually suits that car just awesome.
Yeah. Well, it was a test, really, a product test for us. With the concept paint that we used, because we were never going to go, I've never used it before, we were never going to go to his Monaro using it without trying it.
Okay.
So it was a test. That's why it was painted really, it was a really funny build because it wasn't going to be what it is. We painted it really early.
That's what he thought.
We painted it really early.
Yeah.
You knew all along.
Tell me I'm not going to have hidden wiring. No wiring.
So now, what do you think of it then?
I really like it. Really, really like it. Yeah. So, it's really easy to use, and the clear is beautiful. So, now don't get me wrong. We would prefer to have 2 more weeks with this car before we brought it.
Absolutely.
And it would be much better and
it's
fix a lot of
good. Yeah, second
yeah.
paint.
Yeah, yeah. I know. But
that was out of like 1,000 cars.
But our time frame was Wednesday. 15 hours I buffed it. 15 hours on Wednesday. I was buffing it. That was it on Wednesday.
So, those are racking up. 20 hours.
Yeah,
15.
Hang on. Can I write this down? I keep forgetting it.
Billy's like, shh.
My wife's watching. She's adding all these up. She's like, she's going to send the bill. So,
I don't know my message yet. I don't even know I'm here.
Exactly.
We're on a camping trip at Kettleworth.
But it honestly looks like a car that's had 5 years of planning. I'm going to be honest. It looks like a car that's
done everything on it. Roll cage, tubs,
Everything.
Everything.
Except for the interior,
yeah.
The wiring we didn't do, and a mate, Nathan Hunt, we do the paint together,
yeah.
And that's it. So I do all the blocking, I do all the rubbing, I do all the buffing, I do all that stuff. And sometimes I wish that I could only do one thing.
Yeah.
And I'd be happy just to buff it for someone or just rub it.
Would you really buff?
No, I don't know. Well, if you ask me a few days ago, I would say yes.
He actually told me one day that he'd make you famous, so there you go.
Yeah.
Look what's happened.
Yeah. I know, mate.
We put a little TikTok of it and it's gone crazy. Yeah. So.
Oh, I couldn't thank Paul enough, but because he does that for you, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like
Everyone
thinks that car's easy to do. You can't afford it in the first place if someone helps you.
Yeah.
And you've been around a while. You've done a few...
Yeah.
You haven't painted a lot of cars, but you've done a lot of prep and...
Yeah, that's right.
Cars,
yeah, a lot of cars. So, I worked on... So, Justin's off camera. He won best paint in Summonats. What, JP? Can you remember?
Summonats 4.
Yellow HQ Monaro.
Yep.
Sad they're old.
And then I had a gold HQ four-door that we drove from Queensland. Got down... I think it was top 50 back then, not top 60, I'm not sure. Got in that. Like, we drove it. Like, we were just young. I think that was... Summonats 5. So that's how long we've been around doing that. So
he told me he made you famous, but you actually made him famous.
He wasn't lying. He was a pest. That was true. He was a pest on a pushbike when we were driving around on our cars.
He's a bigger pest now.
And he's 40. We're like, you're supposed to be at home, mate. Go home.
They told me today, I'm the grand champion. It goes on your attitude. They told me to go home.
Yeah, I did.
But that's 100% true. We used to cruise around in our cars back at Redcliffe. Billy was on a push bike, probably 14 or 15, eh, Bill? And just like, we'd go to the next cruise
annoying.
Bit. And he, 100%. And he'd be riding up. And then when he was old enough, he's a concrete and he works hard. You can make fun of him, but he works extremely hard to pay for it.
Yep.
Like crazy hours. And I've done crazy hours, but Bill's done crazy hours to pay for it, 100%.
Yep.
We make a joke that he helped me with the
dip. Of course, yeah.
But he has 100% worked his ass off to pay for it.
Absolutely.
And I know the stress of that as well when we're working together, when we're both stressed, you know what I mean? Like he has to finance the build as well. So, but when he was old enough in my HQ, he used to ring me up to buy it. It's just pest, mate. Ring up all the time. I want to buy your HQ, mate.
It's
like 16-year-old kid trying to buy me a car. Piss off, mate. Like, you know.
Probably struggling to buy CDs.
Well, that's how long sort of we've known each other. So... And I've done a few cars, a lot of little stuff, you know, a lot of mod stuff, you know, setting up over the years. I went out of the industry for a while, and now you come back and you get paid for what you do. Like there was that period
was that good for you? Like,
yeah,
was that
100%,
you think,
100%,
freshen you up sort of?
Yeah, freshen you up and you've got a love for the industry.
Yeah. I mean, I was talking to some guy today and he was asking me about it, and he goes, oh, well, if you can do what you love every day at work or whatever that saying is. And I said, mate, no panel beater's ever said that though.
No.
Like, come on. You're like, it's too hard. So, but he's keeping me out of retirement. So I'd rather retire. Yeah. But he keeps planning everything. Oh, we'll do this next.
I begged for him to do me on Monaro because it had a few dramas with other people as ups and downs.
Yeah.
And then I said to Paul, I'll come and have a look. And I'm like, when can we start? I don't know if I want to do it yet. It's a big job. And anyway, I kind of even got him. And I haven't let him go since.
Yeah. How long is it going to take? You asked me, I said, mate. When it's finished?
That long.
Yeah. And that's true. Bill, he's been, like, as the million stories, really been messed around, by a few people.
Yeah. But I won't give up. Show the young kids you can do it,
Yeah.
That's true.
That's what I'm sensing here. I'm sensing, like, it's like if you really get stuck in, you really want to do it.
Yeah.
You know, like, and some of that's probably down to planning, really well planning. Like you can't just sort of build a gate.
So what's that other saying? It's a bull in a china shop. That's him, right? So when I'm on a 19-hour day working on it, and he's got the ratchet spinner at the front, and I can hear it just ratcheting flat out too fast. I'm like, Billy, just slow down.
You're the pressure regulator. You keep it all.
Yeah.
He's got the trailer backed up. Ready to
I'll tell you what, mate. They should have filmed us. We probably could have had a good reality TV show, mate.
Yeah, exactly.
I was saying that. I'm thinking,
it's been good, bud. It has been good, mate.
And
then they come here, it's amazing to see it. It's never meant to look like that.
Yeah.
And it's not all about just building cars. Like, look at the great times you guys have had together. Like, it's all good life and, you know,
and you wrecked the trailer on the way here to Canberra.
Oh, come on. But I saved the Silverado, mate. How's that? I saved the Silverado, but we punched a hole in the trailer. But it's Bill hasn't been to the shows for a while. Yep. I've been regularly going to the shows, keeping an eye out on the stuff. He hasn't, like, the type of guy that doesn't go to them if he hasn't got a car there, I suppose. Yep.
I showed me
but
car
how much fun was it?
Yep. 8 years, I took, Maguire's about four times, five times.
But how much fun has it been with all the blokes?
Yeah, it's a different...
That we're back here, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, it's good. Good to have you back. So listen, congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for coming to Rocky. Thanks for all the effort.
And what are we...
No, thanks for all the effort for the unveiling. Really do appreciate it. Because, I mean, I'm always harassing you guys to get here, but at the end of the day, I do appreciate it. It's a lot of work.
No problem.
Good show.
Thanks, guys. All
we can say is... What do we say?
Mad.
It's mad.
You know what? I love VLs, so, and I'm building a VL too, so it is mad, mate.
Yeah, it's mad.
Here we are, still at Rocky Nats 1. What an unbelievable event. Lucky enough, I'm here with the current Rocky Nats champion, Paul Hart. Congratulations, mate.
Thank you very much, Webby.
You happy?
Oh, astounded, surprised. Can't believe it's happened. Just can't believe I'm sitting here with you guys.
So go back a little bit.
Yep.
Give us a little bit of your history. So you're a car guy from...
Car guy from way back when Mum wasn't happy about it.
Yeah.
So first car was an EJ wagon. I put a little injected 202 in and I cruised that. And then, you know, family and kids and all that come along. But I've sort of been through everything now. Valiants, Chevs, EH Ute, and now this. And this is the only one in my life now, I guess.
Yeah.
So,
what do you do for a job?
I'm a firey.
Oh.
Yeah. Yep. So I work for Queensland Fire down in Brisbane. Yep.
So what's your background? Are you from Brisbane?
No, from Perth originally, but I learned my trade with the Air Force, working on aircraft. So just sort of always been a tinkerer since I got out.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So give us a little bit of history on this car. Is it how long you had this and how long in the build? And
I bought the car mid-14, started building it about 6 months after that. Mostly done at home with mates. We tubbed it. Mate of mine, Dave Small, gave me a hand with the tubs. We try to do as much as we can ourselves. It's only gone out really for interior and paint, and the rest of the assembly's been at home. So.
One thing I really like, I mean, I love the car in general, but one thing I really like is the original style. It's almost like a restored car. It's original colour, but just all the performance bits and fabrication, and it's amazing.
Oh, thanks very much. We really wanted to keep that factory look. Yeah. We just think Ford got it right with this opal green and the parchment interior. So, yeah, it's mad.
I know it's not a Commodore, Josh, but do you like it?
I do love it. I love the way that you've kept a lot of the originality of the car, but you've done the tweaks you've done aren't over the top, but they're really on point.
Thanks,
I guess. So let's say start from scratch with the car. Did you build a car to drive every day and just be really tidy, or because this is, whether we agree or not, because I know you probably won't, but this is a super tidy car.
Thanks, I really appreciate it. Yeah, we built the car to drive.
Yeah.
So everything was just to drive it, so the motor's not off its head. Still makes like 630 and 580 foot-pound.
Yeah.
But, mate,
that's pretty good, mate.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah.
It's fun.
It's not off its head much.
But, it goes to work twice. When I'm working weekends, it comes to work with me and just sits out in the weather. Yeah. So, yeah.
Plenty of water at work to wash it, no doubt.
A little bit, yeah. It's been plenty of water this weekend. I've got to drive it home tonight in the rain now.
Yeah, wow.
Back to the Airbnb, and then we'll trailer it home tomorrow.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. It's also cool, no doubt, it's part of the champion thing that a lot of them are driven, right?
And that was going to be my point for just so everybody knows. So how Paul won that award, he done well in the judging. He was in street judging, so he done well in the judging, done well in People's Choice, and then we done two events this morning back-to-back. Because of the rain, we had to get them in, and he actually won one and come third in the other. So it was a good all-round performance. So the car judged well and then drove well.
If
you didn't know that, now you know.
No, that's great, yeah.
But the subtle look of the car still keeps like the original styling of the XR, obviously. But when I saw you launch off for the Go to Huera, I'm like 600 and something horsepower, surely, you know.
Yeah, that's,
and then turns out.
Yeah, no, I like that. Like keeping it understated, fun. And I just think nowadays with the they're stylish regardless of how you do them if you keep them to the factory.
So what's it like? Obviously, what's it like to actually drive though? If you really, you know, give it a, you're happy with the way it is?
Yeah, happy with it. We went down to Corral when there was three of us in the car last week. We did 150 return trip, raced it three times, never missed a beat, and it was comfortable enough, quiet enough in the car that we could have a conversation like this.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, and we got back and we didn't feel like we've been beaten around the head. So it was real. Really nice car to drive.
Do you think this is a car, like I like to ask this question, you keep this forever, this car? Are you like a, or is this a car, are you car hoarder like?
No, I actually sold my H Ute to finish this, so I got rid of the Holden to finish the Ford.
Yeah.
So I don't know how that's going to go out there, but this will stay with me for a while now. I can't see much else that I want to build. I'm quite happy. I might refine it a bit.
Yeah.
Maybe put it on the spray at some point.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's about it, really.
Because 630 horsepower is not enough, you know.
No.
Oh, but that would be a bit fun too, especially given that you said you drag race it a bit.
Yeah,
so I've had a bit of bottle will nut out. You know?
Yeah, I like to. It's gone 11.0 at 122, but we had issues. It wasn't on full throttle. I was getting not quite there on my secondaries.
Yeah.
I just want to break it into the tens, and then I'll just see how I go. But we're going to go roll racing next Saturday night, so
I've
already got plans to use the car again.
I was going to ask you, so what else you got coming up? Any other shows? Or?
Well, I think Red Center looks like a goer. That seems like a great event you've put together.
I've been working on a few of these guys.
Yeah. That is a killer event. It is so good.
And regional Australia, mate, how can you not visit it? So.
And your wife, she's part of it, eh? She just...
Yep.
She loved it.
Yeah, she did.
And got the smile off her.
She's really wrapped, I can tell.
She was, yeah. And Jade and Reed McGuinness, who did the interior, they were the ones who really pointed me in the direction of colours. It probably would end up like a patchwork quilt if it was left to me. Probably colourblind, I think. But yeah, so she was, tip of the hat to her.
It was cool. I remember when just before the awards started, we had a bit of a chat.
Yeah.
He was just saying g'day and stuff, and we were having a chat, and you're like, I've no idea why Owen's called me to come here. Like, you literally had no idea.
I just thought Owen was going to say, look, mate, nice car. Why don't you come down to someone else and have a drive there? You might have driven okay. And that's all I thought it was. And all I really come here for this weekend was to enjoy the car. But I thought if I can get like a little mug saying, hey, you're in the top 30 street cars because your chrome looks good, I would have been happy.
Well, the mug would fit in the cupboard. That thing needs a shelf.
Exactly.
That's right, yeah. These engineering permits. Yeah.
Right. Make it right. Yeah. Well done. Well done,
thank
Paul.
You guys.
Well done, mate.
Oh, mate. Yeah, thank you.
Awesome, mate.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks,
well
guys.
Done. All right.
Thank you.
Summer Nats is the place to go. Everybody's here.
Summer Nats would like you to know that there's some exclusive new merch available now. Cool stuff like this, or this, this, and this, and this.
Are we selling G-strings?
What?
There's also merch from previous Summer Nats events, Burnout Masters merch, and more. Be sure to click the Buy Now button to secure your exclusive merch. Mad.
Do I have to give this shirt back? Can I have a free hat?
Mad.
All right, I've just found a guy we've wanted to have on this podcast for quite a few months, so... I got Pat O'Shea from Pat's Pro Restos, and we're obviously still here at Rocky Nats. Welcome, mate.
Cheers, mate. It's good to be up here. Good to come up with some cars. It's been great.
Yeah, so Pat's brought three cars up. First one here behind us is the F100, which we unveiled. Tell us a little bit about this truck, mate.
It's a good family friend, actually. It's his dad's car. It was actually his best mate's car, and he died of cancer too young, so... He bought the car and sat in his shed for a couple of years and decided to, he hit me up for a few years, hey, we're going to do something with this truck, and then about 17 months ago we got serious, and they're 70-year-old and they want to drive it all over the country and do whatever, so we put a 2017 Coyote and everything in it, 6-speed auto, and just build it so they can drive it and have some fun.
And still judge pretty good, so it's a really neat truck. One thing I've known Pat for quite a few years, and one thing I've really noticed about him, you seem to build so many cars and end up really good friends with so many of your customers. They end up friends.
Yeah, we are. Every customer we've ever had in the last 15 or so years, we still have dinner with at different occasions. So no, it's been really good.
Yeah,
really
good social. It's such a great story because it's not always like that. And the other two cars you had here, I don't think the owners were. I think you might have been driving them. Yeah. Is that correct?
Yeah. They trust me. No, we build them, so they trust me. They put me on the insurance policy, and they say, yeah, whatever. You want to take them, do whatever. So yeah, no, it's good.
Well, it's the best. It's the absolute best. Business card you could have, because one of the cars had top undercarriage and top paint overall for the whole show. So that Tirana's awesome.
Yeah, no, it's a cool car. Nathan owns that. He's a good guy. And it's funny, he's not really a car guy, but he's just always on that blown blue hatchback with all the blingy stuff. So that's what we build him. And yeah, it's cool.
Isn't that brilliant? Yeah. I just like to talk about the obviously, you would have talked about the build with the customer and stuff the whole time. I mean,
he
I love the.
Does. That's a really good point with Pat.
Yeah, I love the. I was saying before off air, you could give this car to 100 people, but the way, you know, and they all build it differently. But I love this. This just looks like, really, with the matte finish grille and everything, it kind of looks like you could almost buy it from the factory today if they did resto restores, you know, like Ford.
And that was the point of the build. Like, they didn't want nothing too blingy or too out there, just something reliable. And like I said, even these people, I'm good mates with their son. I built an ex-wife from years ago, and we've been mates since we were kids. So I just want to build them something really reliable, really clean, and, you know, like something they'd really enjoy. And just want to do a little bit different to everyone else too, like not customise it too much, but just make it almost look factory fitted and styling. And yeah, the satin grill, there's a few arguments in the workshop about that. They all wanted to paint a body colour, but I said, nah, nah, nah. And then they all ate their words. I said, yeah, okay, we agree with you. But yeah, so no, it's just a good, clean truck.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, you were telling me that it drives really well too. Tell us about the front end and stuff and a few of the other parts.
Yeah, we put Car Guys Garage from Melbourne, Mark's front and rear end in it. So yeah, it's all BABF Falcon front suspension and brakes and coilover shocks and then 4-bar rear. And yeah, it's got the Cody, obviously, 2017 Cody, 440 horsepower, 6R80 6-speed auto, and yeah, 9-inch. So yeah, it's got aircon, steer, central locking, push button start, all the stuff. So yeah, it should be a cool thing to drive.
I reckon you could take because this is a global car, really, this model of car, right? You could take this to any car show in the world.
They are so popular in the States. Yeah. The, like, early F100s were, but now these are just off the head in the States, aren't they?
F trucks are going silly now. Man.
You could take this. I looked at this, as soon as I saw this under when it got unveiled, I'm like, you could take that car to any car show in the world, and then people would go, wow, that's that's like really great, you know? What's it? Yeah.
And he wanted to keep it true to his best mate that passed away of cancer. Because it's not quite the factory colour. We used the Glaserit Profi chips, a little bit brighter. The original colour is similar shade, but more washed out. And it had stripes on it before. That's why we sort of went the stripe design. Just changed a bit, but still kept it true to...
It's got a real factory feel, the stripe, though, you know? It's kind of...
Yeah, just try to keep it that 70 sort of style. And 20-inch steelies and stuff on it. Just didn't want to go too blingy on it.
Yeah.
And even the interior, it's really, really good. But again, it's a saddle, it's understated.
It's just simple, and everyone looks at me and just goes, wow, it's nice, without being too overdone.
I want to ask you a question, which you probably can't answer, and that is, how many cars do you reckon you have actually built and had out there on the circuit, do you know? This is in about 10 years, by the way.
Well, in say this is our 10th show in 10 years, basically a big show as far as unveils. We've unveiled 12 new cars in 10 years.
Yeah, wow.
So at MotorX, Brisbane Hot Rod Show, or Rocky Nuts or Summer Nuts.
Yeah,
wow. The big events.
That's pretty amazing. So to do that...
Do you have any fingerprints left from
all that? But to do that, you must have a pretty good crew.
We do. I've got a good bunch of guys, mate. Sadly, we lost one of my guys earlier this year. He's only 49 of cancer, and he'd been with me 11 years. So that still affects you every day. And he was that tradesman you just can't replace, mate. He was one of those guys it takes two guys to replace. And he actually did a lot of the early work on this truck. So that was sort of why we pushed to get it here as well. So it's his memory. But no, mate, we've got an awesome bunch of guys. They're all up here now. They're all packing up while I'm talking to you guys. But no, they all come up. We make a weekend of it. And that's what we do. We just try and keep a family environment. The Custers, the boys. We just make more of a social thing, not about the car. The car's just something on the side, really.
Well, it's what I've been saying for a few years now. It just brings all good people together,
doesn't it?
It
really
does. It's the catalyst. Yeah.
It is.
So in saying that, I'm guessing you've got a few good things in the build.
We do, mate. We've always got something in the build, but we've got a couple. A really, really good thing, hopefully, have ready for MotorX, and then we've got another Street Elite style 54 Chev we might try and have ready for MotorX as well, so we'll see how we go. But we've got 12 or 13 in the build, about 8 or 9 waiting to come in the build. So, yeah, we've got plenty to do,
And I've made a comment over this event to just people who are asking and news crews and that this industry just seems to be booming, and the biggest issue I feel in the whole industry is that there's just not enough good people to build the cars.
There's not. And there is a handful of good shops around and stuff, and you always hear different stories about everyone. It is what it is. But
exactly.
That's in every industry is the same. You get your good and your bad. I just think the biggest thing in our industry is a lot of people get a bit lost on their way a little bit. They get guided and whatnot, but you know, and a lot of people, especially guys that can't do the car themselves, they're relying on us to build them for them.
Absolutely.
The cost and stuff can get out of control. So you really got to, you know, work that out.
You've got to manage that,
So.
And one thing that you do, and I've talked about it quite a few times in the podcast, is this whole project planning, and where you get the rendering done. So much of it is back to
just
planning, isn't
communication.
It?
Communication. Yeah. So you really need to know what they want, and we always go above and beyond, make sure they get more than they pay for, but you know, you just got to try and be realistic as well.
Yeah. All right, mate. Look, I really appreciate your time. Like I said, I've been trying to get you on here for a few months, so it was a great time to catch up. Awesome weekend, and I hope you had a good weekend.
Yeah, no, it's been an awesome weekend. No, we had a ball. So it was fun up here. We'll be up here next year again too. So, no, we had a ball. It's been great.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you.
Rocky Nuts, mate. We've been talking about this for ages, about get your entries in, get your spectator tickets. I'll tell you what.
Get your entries in.
for next year.
Get your entries in next year. But everybody got their entries in. There was 1,200 plus cars here.
Yeah, it was crazy. And just as you would seen through those, the excitement from the people. That was only four people we just interviewed. But over the weekend, we talked to many people and just the excitement, the emotion, and just it was just awesome, wasn't it? What an event.
What an event. And I noticed it at all of them, but you sort of go away from an event for a few months and you come back. The sense of community spirit of this, the automotive community, honestly, is the best one.
I think it's actually got better in the last, just probably 4 or 5 years. And I've just realised that there's this, well, I have known for a long time, but there's so many good people. Yeah. And because we're going to all these different events, it's almost like coming to, almost like family.
The family vibe, definitely.
Like good family. Not the ones you want to spend time with.
Not the ones you ring up Christmas dinner and run away. No,
yeah, exactly.
Not those ones. But good to chat with those guys.
Yeah, really good. Billy and Paul, they're great guys. Look, they're all great guys, great cars. And I'm sure a lot of those guys are just, they've got the bug again. A lot of talk about going to Red Centre. Obviously, we've got four qualifiers for Motorex, so bring it on.
Tell us, so a lot of the winners tonight, people we've seen here won stuff, they will end up at other events.
Yeah, absolutely. What we had here is we've given away four Superstars qualifiers, that's for Motorex. And then plus with Rare Spares, such awesome sponsors for this event, they gave a $250 voucher for five vehicles and free entry to Summer Nats. Yeah. So it's a good way of
I think Rare Spares is a great fit for Rocky Nats. Yeah, it is. Great fit.
Yeah, I'm sure. They had a couple of stands down on the river and... Yeah, I think they had a good weekend too.
It's Sunday, mate. You've been here for a week now. Ready to go home tomorrow, no doubt? Home in the morning. It's been a great event. Walt Gersikowski taking out Burnout Master Champion.
How good was that?
His skid had the arms on my... hairs on my arms standing up and my right eardrum pretty much blown out. But well done to Walt on that.
So is this our last podcast for a while?
This is our last podcast for a while, mate.
Ah, it is indeed.
It is indeed. There will be an announcement coming in the future soon about what we're going to do after this.
I really enjoyed it. And what I've really enjoyed...
We've done 50-something.
As I've said it a couple of times over the events, over the podcast, but some of the people have just been amazing. And that's... people have come to me at this event and said, you had the designer from Holden, you had Ron Goodman racing Porsches around the
Barry
world.
Barry Hall.
Barry, just the people we've had. And
it's crazy,
Yeah, all the people. So I actually feel very fortunate to be part of it. And I thank all of those people that have been out there that have been on it. And, of course, all you listeners. Awesome.
Any of those people that we've had on any of the 50 or so podcasts, they could walk around here. They're all car heads.
Absolutely.
You know, like Barry, look at how passionate he is about cars. You know, think about some of the people we've had. All right. That's it, mate.
Cheers.
We'll see you soon.
And he's mad.
You're mad, mate. See ya.